We're starting out by understanding the laws of prayer. By understanding the laws of prayer. I'm still only getting it in one ear. By understanding the laws of prayer. And knowing that after we get through praying, we want to make sure that we've prayed right. And the reason why we're not seeing the results that we desire to see is because we're praying fervently, but we're not praying right. And I don't know about you, but I want answered prayers. I want answered prayers. I just don't want to get up and been crying and wailing out and still don't see any results. Amen, somebody. So the book of Matthew, the 6th chapter, says in the 9th verse, after this manner therefore pray ye. No. Go ahead. After this manner therefore pray ye, our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. And how many remember that from last week? How many certainly remember that from last week? And I don't know about you, but I've been, yes, that was it. I don't know about you, but I've been getting some powerful results from thy kingdom come. Anybody else in here got the same testimony? We found out that when we say thy kingdom come, what do we get, people of God? All that God is. Say that again. When I say thy kingdom come. Come on, say it like you mean it. When I say thy kingdom come. I get all God is. That means all of heaven become accessible to me. And I lack nothing. Amen. That's it. That's it. So he said, after this manner, pray. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. And we add a very profound part of today's lesson, because I can really see now just the how smart God is in the way that he does things. Because when you begin to talk about hallowed be thy name and making thy name holy, and as the book of Malachi said, making the name of God above every name. Then you recognize that when you begin to come into the presence of God. And how many people, today is your first day in prayer? Today is your first day in prayer. Today is your first day in prayer. Okay, then I will back up just a little bit. When you begin to come into the presence of the Lord and you begin to name the names of God and worship those names and begin to exalt those names, Jehovah Jireh, Jehovah Nisi, Jehovah Shalom, Jehovah Sitkenu. What begins to happen is you begin to pull down the presence of the Lord. And that's what you want to do. No time do you ever want to pray and come out of that prayer without having pulled down the presence of the Lord. And nothing activates God like worshiping his name. And what do I mean by activate? When you say, oh God, I praise you because you are Jehovah Jireh, then what you're doing is you're activating your provision for that day. Are you understanding what I'm saying? That means everything that you're going to need for that day, he's got to provide it, because you have exalted his name above everything that you need. Do you see what I'm saying? And therefore, he comes down in your need. Why does he come down in your need? Because you brought him down. Come on, somebody. Because you brought him down. Because you ushered him into that need. And that's why he said, I know what you are in need of even before you ask. So then begin to worship me for who I am, and you'll get who I am. Come on, somebody say amen right there. Amen to that. So when we begin to worship the names of God, and we begin to worship God for who he is, we get to the next level, because we then invite the presence of God in our homes. See, we're coming in here learning how to pray, and we're going to do some what we call corporate praying in the sanctuary. But But what you're really learning to do is how to pray like this at home all the time. Because you yourself want results all the time. You just don't want to wait until you get to the sanctuary and wait till you get to your prayer partner before you can get a breakthrough. You want to be able to get a breakthrough by yourself. You want to be able to speak to the wind and it obeys you. You want to be able to bind the devil and he actually goes by your command. Amen, somebody. Not just the pastors or prophetess Bottoms or somebody. God is trying to let you understand that you have more power than you know. You walking around with a big Shondo car and not knowing that you got power. Power to shut the enemy down. Power to put shackles on his feet. When you begin to worship God like that, he can't even come in your vicinity. It builds a hedge around you. It builds a hedge around your house. It builds a hedge around your family. Come on, somebody. He's trespassing. That's why you can command him to go. Come on, somebody. Because if God have adopted us into the royal family and we are now the priesthood of God, then God didn't even tolerate Satan being in his presence. When he got disconnected from him, he threw him out. Come on, somebody. And everything that God does, it's him showing you what you have the authority to do. Don't let him stay in your presence. Don't let him stay in your house. Don't let him stay in your mind. He has to go when you say go. Oh, come on, somebody. You need to understand that. And you need to grab authority in your prayers. You know, it's all right to say, oh, God, this thank you, Jesus, done this prayer, you done it. I just want you to just help me. That's not the prayers of the righteous. That's the prayers of the weak. That's the prayers of those that don't know their God. Come on, somebody. Said, when we know our God, we shall do great and mighty exploits. Now, you're only talking to those that know our God. And that's why he said that the prayers of the righteous avail much. Because when there is no partition between you and God, when there's nothing about your life that is interfering with that main line, you're going to get some power. Come on. It's just like plugging in a socket, you know, when you want to turn the light on. You go, what's wrong with the light? Well, is it the light bulb? And you go change the light bulb. But if there's something wrong with some kind of interference there, you're not going to get the power. But when you lay down everything in your life and surrender everything to God, and you know that there's no interference, then you know that just like Jeremiah 33:3 said, when he said, call upon me and I will answer you and show you great and mighty things, you know that God has got to do what you ask him to do because there's no interference. Oh, somebody say amen right there. So we get to the part that when he said, thy kingdom come, all that God is, begin to come. Now, what is the purpose of us hallowing his name and first and then his kingdom coming? Because the purpose of all that God is coming to the earth, first of all, the purpose of our prayers, prayer is not for us to get into prayer telling God all of what we need in the first place. That's that kindergarten stuff. That's not why you pray. You pray not so you can tell God what's wrong, because he already knows what's wrong. Come on, somebody. And a lot of times we've been taught that. Get in prayer. Tell God about it. Well, no. He already know about it. What this group of people is going to learn differently is that when I get in prayer, I'm not going into prayer to tell God about it. I'm going into prayer to get the answer so I can pray the answer. Come on, somebody. Come on. I'm going to stay in his presence as long as it takes until the kingdom of God is opened up to me and he began to speak to me about Junebug. He began to speak to me about my marriage. He began to speak to me about my family. And once I get a word from him, then I begin to pray what he has said to me. And then I shall have whatsoever I pray. Oh, come on, saints. So we're not doing a lot of ridiculous, you know, jargon in the presence of God. Oh, God, help my marriage. You understand? You see what my marriage is going through. And oh, God, you help me. Oh, God, you fix it. Oh, God, I need some money. I need, you know, a house. I need da-da-da. No. You come into the presence of God giving him back his word. Come on, saints. God, you said you shall supply all of my needs which are in heaven. And so now I bless your name for my new house. I bless your name, God. I praise you because I'm moving. I praise you because you're making provision. You're looking for it right now for me. I praise you, God, because it's a matter of time I'm going to meet my divine connection. It's a matter of time when I'm going to get to the right bank and speak to the right bank. And I bless you right now. And as a matter of fact, I'm going to show you I believe you. I'm going to the grocery store, I buy a box and start packing my stuff because I know in whom I believe. See that right there, right there, right there, right there. That was prophecy, somebody. See, anybody looking for a house, see, you gotta, listen, you gotta step out on faith. You gotta leave here, honey, and go get you a box. If you don't do nothing but put six things in it and mark on the outside, move it. Somebody said, what's that, honey? My faith in action right there. What's that? That's me doing what God has revealed to me is going to happen. Are you giving me what I'm saying? Go and get a picture of that car and put it up and paste it everywhere in your house. Say, what's the honey? That's my new car. I'm going to be driving that right there because that's what God said. So what are you doing? Are you asking God? No, I'm pulling it down. Come on here, somebody. I'm pulling it to me. I'm staying connected in prayer until I get everything that heaven is. To all of what's in heaven is here in my life. Oh, y'all, I bless the Lord for that. So he said, you get in the presence of the Lord to keep heaven and earth connected.
Amen. Amen.
Oh, have mercy. That's why I pray every day.
Yes.
To keep heaven and earth connected.
Jesus.
Like a pipeline.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Like a gas line. See, the reason why we can go to the gas station and pull up to the pump and go pay our money and get that thing out. And Dr. Johnson, when we stick it down in that little nozzle, you know, we ain't questioning whether or not we're going to get some gas. Come on. Because the pump is connected to the pipeline. Come on, saints. And the pipeline is running underneath the ground connected to where the oil well is. But if you disconnect that pipeline, you don't get no gas. Come on, saints. Then you can't drive. Come on, saints. If you disconnect yourself in prayer, you don't get no gas. And then you not, you ain't driving, you're being driven. Come on here. Come on here. You got to stay connected every day. Let's see that right there. I want to give you enough excitement to say, I got to pray every day. Because I got to make sure that all that God is made accessible to me all the time. So when he says here, thy kingdom come, what really got me is when he said, thy will be done. Thy will be done. He said many of us don't receive the prayer that we pray is because we don't pray according to the will of God. We pray according to our desires. Let's talk about this will. The natural will is the mental faculty by which one deliberately chooses or decides on a course or action. Then your will is what decisions you make and how you do things. Now, where do I get that will from? I got that will because, Lord have mercy, and as sweet as, you know, our parents and grandparents and everybody, you know, is and whatever, and some of us are worse than others. Because I know when I was younger, you know, I had that falling out spirit too. You know, about 2 or 3 years old, you want something, your mom said, no, you have to fall all out. You know, just fall out and go to holler. And so I used to fall out and go to holler until my mother just said, wherever you fall out at, I'm going to fall out with you. And so what I didn't know back then is she was breaking my will. Come on, somebody. She was trying to teach me at an early age that the thing that you think you want right now is not what you need. Y'all ain't saying nothing. See, I wanted that sucker right before dinner. And she would say, no, it ain't nothing wrong with having the sucker, but it's the wrong timing. And so, see, some of us, we get into the presence of God, you know, falling out. You know, I want a car right now. I want a house right now. Come on, somebody. I want God to do it right now. And God is saying, wrong timing. The reason why it hasn't come, because that's not my will right now. Come on, I'm talking to somebody here right now. See, that's your will. Because God already knows. Well, you know what? What prophet is buying? I know I'm ready for a car. I know I'm ready for a new car. You should see my car. My car is all broke down, and you know I'm ready for a car. And I know that you're not. And God knows that you're not. Because when you go out to your car right now, you got McDonald's fries and chips and all that kind of stuff embedded into the carpet and chewing gum and y'all stand up. It seats all dirty, dashboard all dirty. You don't even wash the rag anymore. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. Oh, I know I'm ready for me a new house. And when I get my new house, I'm going to have me a beautiful house, a white carpet, and ain't nobody going to step on my car. They going to the back door. God said, that's why I can't give it to you. Because how you going to buy white carpet and make folk come to the back door? Can I take off your shoe? Don't touch that. Get in your car. Don't lean against my mirror. Oh, wait a minute. Your head greasy. Don't lean back on my seat. No, you're not ready for a new car. Y'all ain't saying nothing. You ain't ready for it. You're not ready for it. You ain't ready for a new house. Oh, and I just look. I'm chasing. I'm just praying to God to give me a husband. No, you're not ready for a husband. You don't even love God right. You cheat on him. You're not even committed to him. Lord, I ain't gonna get no amen today. I know I'm ready. No. Look at that. Some of y'all came to prayer. Come on, get up at 5 o'clock. All mad. No, you're not ready for a husband. Y'all ain't saying nothing. God said, you're not sensitive to me yet. You don't even treat me right. You don't even spend quality time with me. Come on, somebody said, not my will. But thine will be done. The will of man is the power to arrive at one's own decision and to act on it independently in spite of opposition. What do I mean by that? Your will is the thing when obstacles are being thrown away, you're still trying to get it. Talk about it's the devil. Say, not bad you right now. I bound you. I know I'm going to get this thing. I bound you. And sometimes oppositions are not the enemy. Y'all, I ain't getting no amens right there. Sometimes the warfare that you're experiencing is not the enemy. It's your own desire. And if we would be that strong toward the will of God, the way we are about our own desire, we would be mighty giants in God. See, the will is as one wishes. Now, when you say as one wishes, that means I have not thought that thing out to the end, because I have not been in the divine presence of God. Because I have not been in the divine presence of God, Jeremiah 33, he has not shown me great and mighty things. He has not revealed the mystery of it to me. Are you hearing me? Because I have not been in the presence of God, I don't know the depth and the height of that thing. Y'all ain't saying nothing. So then when I'm in the presence of the Lord, I'm asking according to my wishes. You know, God, I will. Just like, perfect example. I had a sister that was on crack for 15 years. And so we were praying for my sister. Now somebody said, well, you know what? Now, was y'all praying according to the will of God? Yes, because some things across the board is the will of God. It is not God's will that no man should perish. So you can pray for your loved ones to be saved, knowing that you are praying in God's will. But see, the only time things start getting really fuzzy is when you start praying for stuff, husbands, and wives. Lord have mercy. That's when it gets cloudy. See, as long as you pray that God would bring the power in the church, that's his will. As long as you pray that God would put a greater anointing on your pastor, that's his will. As long as you pray that God would bind the enemy out of your marriage, that's his will. As long as you pray that God will bring salvation to your children, that's his will. But I don't know about a Cadillac. Woo, my God, y'all ain't saying nothing. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. I don't know about a diamond ring. I don't know about a necklace or an outfit. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I done lost you. Come on. Go to Luke 22 and 42. Because I done lost you right there. Just look at me. Just blink. Well, does that mean I mean I get my house? You might not. Y'all understand? Because guess what, saints of God? Let me just help you with something. He blesses us according to our maturity level. Y'all ain't saying nothing. He said, you shall prosper even as your soul prosper. So your spirit can't be in the basement and you asking God for a Cadillac. It don't work like that. I'm not getting no amens right there. See, y'all getting low on me right there. A few minutes ago, y'all was all up high. I didn't even start praying. Y'all were, come on, keep that same old spirit now. Where's all that Shango, Kosika, Godika? Where is it at? I don't quite hear that no more. See, because understand something. The way you're able to get in prayer, and he said that there is a prayer of faith. There is a prayer of request. The way you're able to make a request, don't ever make a request higher than your grade in your character, because you ain't going to get it. Oh, did I just help somebody right there? Am I ministering right there? Don't be all out there smoking and drinking and cussing and carrying on themselves. I'm touching and agreeing on this cat like right here. Because you said, God, that if I speak it, I shall have it. You won't have it. Lord, I'm not getting no advance right there. Somebody said, according to your soul prospering. Now let me throw a curve right here. Because a lot of y'all said, well, you know what? I wouldn't all have been God and God blessed me. But did God really bless you with it? Did God really bless you with it? Because see, that there is a satanic curve that the devil throws to. And he'll bless you in your mess to keep you from ever getting to purification. Come on here, saints. He'll let you get a car. He'll let you get a new house. And you're not purified. And that's to deceive you into thinking that you're somewhere in God that you're not. Y'all ain't saying that. That's why the word said heaven and earth is going to pass away. But my word shall forever stand. Tell somebody, say, you better get his word and know that you got it. See, you don't measure success in prayer by stuff. You measure success in prayer by power, honey. Oh, y'all, because you get a Cadillac don't mean you got power in prayer. Come on, somebody, because the devil can get a Cadillac. The devil can get a house. But can the devil, y'all ain't saying, but can the devil bind the enemy? I gotta stop, but I'm getting ahead of myself right there. Look what I got in prayer. Look at toys. Until God begin to do something on the inside of me, that I don't even look. I'm not thinking about no toys. I'm not thinking about no car. I'm not thinking about no house. I want to be able to walk in places, and the devil know I'm there. I want all the hell to know when I wake up. I want the bottom of the pit to say she's up. Saints, come on here, saints. I'm talking about power. Just tell somebody, I'm talking about power, real power. I'm talking about power. Power to move traffic. I'm talking about power. Power to speak on your job and knowing that there is no more positions, but you can speak a raise that you ain't got. I'm talking about power. I'm talking about a boss that's been riding you for years, and you come in here and get the power of prayer and speak and pray, and all of a sudden your enemies become your footstool. I'm talking about power, not toys. You ought to touch somebody right now and say, how did forget the toys? I want some power. Honey, I'd rather walk and got the anointing. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. I'd rather live in a project and know I can move mountains. Come on, y'all got that thing mixed up. A lot of y'all in prayer because you want toys. But God said, you better get your mind on right, honey. What I want to give you is greater than toys. It's bigger than a house. It's bigger than a car. It's the anointing that destroys the yoke. It's the yoke-breaking anointing. I said I wasn't gonna do this. Mother, I said I wasn't gonna do this today. I said I was gonna come in here and I was gonna be nice.
because in Luke, the 22nd chapter, at the 42nd verse there, it says, saying, he said, and he withdrew, 41st verse, 22 and 41, and he withdrew from them about a stone's throw, and knelt down, and did what, saints? He prayed, saying, Father, if what? If you are willing, remove this cup from me. Yet not what? My will. But the Amplified Bible said, always yours be done. I'm talking about coming in here and learning. Lord, I love you for this one right here. Learning how to embrace suffering as power. See, I'm talking about praying from the third level now. Because see, the first level said, give me a car, give me a house. Second level say, give me a ministry. Third level say, whatever this thing is that you want me to go through, if it's going to bring some power, then my answer is yes. Oh, I'm not hearing nobody say nothing right there. That's the kind of prayer that I want to pray, that when suffering comes my way, I'm not trying to get out of the suffering, but I'm allowing God to create something new inside of my spirit behind whatsoever it is I suffer. Jesus right there, one time I did. Now, you know what? I'm praying that you would give us a chariot because we're tired of walking. Now, we're walking all across the country trying to do your will. I'm praying right here that you, Lord, will give us something to ride. He said, no, you know what? My will, my flesh, don't want to go through this. Come on, somebody. I'm talking to somebody in here. Because see, a lot of y'all say, well, God, you don't know what I'm going through. And my husband, my this, and my that, and my that. And God just keeps saying to me, how in the world do you think that I'm ever going to give you a relationship with me unless there's some things that I don't fix right away? Oh, my God. See, all of us want to get out of pain. Fix this, God, fix it. This is hurting me. Oh, I'm just in so much tear. I can't take no more. But see, understand something. It is the suffering that brings about the power. Lord, I wish I had somebody. Well, prophet's mind, what do you mean by that? Because when you get to the point that you can't take no more, then what you do is you draw on the third realm of God. Come on, and then you begin to experience an anointing in God that you've never tapped before. God, I wish I had somebody. And that's why God don't fix it always. And that's why God don't always work it out when you want him to work it out. Because God has said, I'm trying to give you something bigger. I'm trying to give you something greater. I'm trying to go, no, it ain't about your problem. It's about what I'm trying to give you. Some of them just said, I don't want it. Whatever it is he's trying to give me, he can give me. Because y'all ain't saying that. Because you know what? I don't want it. See, he's trying to birth long suffering. I ain't getting nobody to say that. But what do you mean by long suffering? He said, I'm trying to train your spirit how to praise me and maintain the power of God when everything around you is going backwards. Oh, y'all ain't saying that. I ain't getting but about 30 amens right there. He said, because if what I'm giving you can still operate in the midst of opposition, then that's power. Some of y'all praising God right now, and the person next to you don't know what kind of hell you're going through. See, that's power. Why do I say that's power? Because I have tapped a level in God that I'm rested in my spirit, because I know that all things work together for the good to them that love God, to them that are called according to his purpose. Are y'all hearing? And listen, I'm able to praise God. I'm able to give thanks because I know that this is the will of God concerning me. Not my will, but thine will be done. morning, and I was thinking about my will. I said, well, okay, well, if this is my will and my will fights God, then do you break my will? Do you, how does that happen? So the Lord began to say to me, he said, it's like a balloon that's got helium in it. If you hold it on to the string, that's your will. That balloon is not going any higher than you are in height. Y'all ain't saying that. And to some little child who's looking up at you with the balloon, oh, wow, look at that. You know, that's how we are with each other as Christians, you know. When one of us is a little higher than the other, look at what he doing in the spirit. Balloon way up there. That big old balloon just float. Y'all ain't saying that. But see, as long as you got that balloon, it encourages you into thinking that you are doing something for God. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And so you're getting your reward now, because everybody said, whoa, look at you. That's powerful. Oh, you really preached. Oh, you really sang. But God is saying that the power in that balloon is being limited because you're holding on to it. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. He said, you ain't seen God do nothing in your life until you let the balloon go. Because when you let the balloon go, honey, that balloon is going places that you never thought that it would be able to go. It'll go to another city. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Woo! My God, let the balloon go. That's your will. And God is saying, if you get in prayer and just let the balloon go, I can take you somewhere. I can do something with you. When I fight the will of God, how do I know that my spirit is not submitted? Because when you come into prayer and the first thing you do is come in there telling God what you want, what you need, what's got to be done. Life's going out tomorrow. You got to pay this bill, God. Then already you have entered into a battleground with the Holy Spirit. Already you are getting ready to waste time in prayer. But when you walk into prayer and your first comment to God is, I'm worshiping him, and then said, God, you know everything about me. So God, in spite of everything, let your will be done. See, I'm talking about growing up now, y'all. I'm not talking about being in kindergarten. I'm talking about growing up now. That means if God turned the lights out, if he let them go out, you still able to get a candle and say, that's all right. Because you know what? God already knew what I needed. Come on here, somebody. He's already able. He could have worked a miracle. Since he didn't, maybe my attitude is being tested in my trial. I'm talking about real prayer now. I ain't talking about that Mickey Mouse stuff. He kept my lights on. He kept my gas bill on. Ooh, thank you, Jesus. Oh, Lord, he let me pay my note. Ooh, he fixed it. I'm not talking about that level right there. Turn with me to Colossians 1 and 9 so we can pray. Because Lord God, he can do something up in here. He can do something up in here. How do you get rid of the will? How do you handle that thing? He said, you have to dissolve it in my presence. It has to be dissolved in my presence. That's why I know people ain't getting in this presence, people now. 1 and 9. Watch this, y'all. Watch what this thing does. He says, for this reason, we also, from the day we heard of it, have not ceased to pray and make special requests for you, asking that you may be filled with the full, deep, and clear knowledge of what? No, of what, saints? So what should we be praying? For the full knowledge of his will. What is your will concerning my situation, Lord? Now you see it, but what is your will? The Lord spoke a word to me a couple of weeks ago about the two major situations that's happening in my family. And I said, God,
I said, this thing is really bad. I said, you know, two different incidents and my family in Chicago is really going through a big thing with the media and all that. And I said, well, what in the world? And when God began to give me the answer, then I don't care how many times one of my relatives called me and said, and guess what happened today? And I said, I don't care what happened. I know what God said. Well, guess what happened today? I don't care what that is. I know what God said. Well, you know what? It's really bad. No, I don't care. I know what God said. Come on. See, when you get the mind of God and the will of God concerning your circumstance, then I don't care how bad it looks. You stand on what God said. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. See, that's what makes you have peace. That's what makes you have confidence. That's why when everybody in your family is falling apart, you still say, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Don't you see what's going on? Yes, I do. But why aren't you? You ain't hurt either. You know, I'm trying to be hurt. But I'm too far behind the veil to feel it. Because feelings ain't back here. Come on here. Honey, wait. No. Where I am in God, I can't feel my feelings. Because flesh is not allowed back here. Emotions is not allowed back here. The only thing that's allowed behind the veil is the word of God. Come on here, somebody. The word of God. If you still feeling it, you haven't gone deep enough. If it still troubles you, you still too low. Who am I preaching to today? If you still worrying about that situation, you have not gone deep enough in the presence of God. You still sticking out somewhere. Your little will. Watch this. Your will got your feelings still hurt. Somebody to say amen right there. Your will got you still offended. Come on. Your will got you still hurt. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Honey, there are six things I can name you right now that I'm going through that I don't feel it. I don't think y'all understand what I'm saying. I don't feel it. I should be feeling it. I should be depressed. I should be ready to quit. But I don't feel it. You know why? Because I'm in Christ. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I'm not in the church. I'm in the presence of the Lord. And guess what? I know now that I'm going through so much right now that I can't afford not for one second to get out of the presence of God. Are you hearing me? Because the minute I step out, I'm going to be devoured. And that's why every day of your life, you got to pray to stay in the presence of God so you can live with peace of mind and life abundant. Tell somebody, you're too low. Tell them, you still feel it, you're too low. Tell them, you worried right now, you're too low. You depressed right now, come on up right now into another realm. I said, tell them, if you still depressed, come up in another realm, you're too low. Hallelujah. How many people being blessed right now? Because I see it. That's why you got to go to praising God when you get the next set of news. Hallelujah. Thank you. Thank the Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be the God. Because I know it's a puzzle to me, but I know it ain't no mystery to you, God. Because you're the one that's in control of this thing. You know the outcome. You know the income. You know how the puzzle going to come together. And all I know is that if I stay in your presence, when the end comes, my soul shall be satisfied. I will be able to say it is well with my soul. Read this so we can get through right quick. It said that you may walk and live and conduct yourself in a manner worthy of the Lord, fully pleasing Him. Let me go back up to this scripture. For this reason, we also, from the day we heard of it, have not ceased to pray and make special requests for you, asking that you may be filled. Somebody say, filled. Not touched. Say, filled. That you may be filled with the full, deep, and clear knowledge of His will in all spiritual wisdom. Look at that. In comprehensive insight into the ways and purposes of God, and in understanding and discernment of what saints? Of what saints? Of spiritual
if you be willing and obedient, you shall do what? No, I didn't hear that. You should do what? Eat the what? Which means you don't have to come into his presence begging for stuff. Just get willing and obedient. Let me help you to see what the devil is trying to stop you from having. Reason why he want to keep you in your will. I didn't see this until this morning. God said to me, that's why you got to let this thing dissolve in my presence, because you don't know what you're missing. That's what God told me. So you don't know what you're missing. Now I'm going to go over here in the King James Version, because I want you to see something. The ninth verse again says, I'm going to go to 1 and 9. It says here, get this, for this cause, we also, since the day we heard it, are you hearing this? Do not cease to pray for you and to desire that you might be filled with the knowledge of his will and all wisdom and spiritual understanding, that ye may walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful. Did y'all see that? Fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God. Now, in my Bible, it has a semicolon there. Now, in English, when there's a semicolon there, it says that everything that's being said in this particular verse is directly connected to the foundation of that first verse. Are you seeing that? Which means, it means go back to the next verse. It means refer back to what you just read. In other words, everything that you're going to get in the 10th verse and the 11th verse is done hinged upon verse 9. So then it should read like this in the 10th verse, that ye may walk worthy of the Lord unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work and increasing in the knowledge of God, after you have been filled with the knowledge and the wisdom. Are y'all seeing that? Are you seeing that? After you have been given the deep discernment of the will of God and you have knowledge, you're going to get the power to be worthy to walk pleasing. And then you ain't got to beg for stuff because you're going to be fruitful. Did you just get that? Being in his will keeps you fruitful. Did you see that? Dropping your will makes you fruitful. Are you seeing that? Watch this, 11th verse. Strengthen with all might according to his glorious power unto all patience and long-suffering with joyfulness, semicolon. Y'all see that? That you may be filled with the knowledge of the will in all wisdom and spiritual understanding. That means when I get in his will, I'm going to have what? Patience, long-suffering, joyfulness, and power. Giving thanks unto the Father, which hath made me to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints in what? Life. Nothing is hid from me when I get in his will. Who have delivered from the power of darkness and have translated us into the kingdom of the dear Son, in whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sin. Who is the image of the invisible God, the firstborn of every creature? For by him were all things created that are in heaven and that are in earth, visible and invisible, whether they be thrones or dominions or principalities or powers. All things were created by him for him. And he is before all things, and by him all things consist. And he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead. And in all things he might have, what, saints? Preeminence. That means, stopping there, when I get in the will of God, if I were to read this backwards, I am gaining preeminence over thrones, over kingdoms, over worlds. Y'all ain't saying nothing. Over principalities, over powers. I am walking in wealth and riches. I have an inheritance. I walk in victory and power. Come on, somebody. I have knowledge of all things. Nothing is hid from me. I got insight concerning all details. I stay in the light. I never deceived. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I never want for anything. I never need anything. Everything that's about me is subdued under me. All things that come at me comes beneath me. Because what? I'm in his will. Did y'all see that? That's why the cry has to be today, not my will. because my will doesn't give me preeminence. My will doesn't give me power. My will doesn't make me fruitful. My will get me a temporary high, but not showing me all of what I could have had. Y'all ain't saying nothing. My will get me a car, but without victory in my spirit. Y'all ain't saying nothing. My will get me a house without peace of mind. Come on, y'all ain't saying nothing. Y'all ain't saying nothing here. My will get my kids to church, but not get them delivered. My will get my husband reading his Bible, but never making a full commitment. Come on, I'm trying to show you how much power you got. None. None. Power for temporary change. Come on, somebody. Power for temporary illusions. Are you hearing what I'm saying? But what God is saying is, when we begin to cry, not my will, but thine will be done today, he said, I'm going to dissolve your will. I'm going to begin to make you satisfied with everything that's in me. I'm going to begin to make you satisfied with my will and not yours. And listen, the first thing that we ought to say, God, if it be your will, Lord, whatever your will is, let it be done. And do you not know when you say that, my sister, everything about you began to light up faster than it does when you start praying for individual stuff? Because the Bible says you know not what you are to pray for, but the Spirit of the Lord knows all things. He knows. See, while you're here talking about, God, give me some strength, give me some strength, give me some strength, God over here saying, you know what? I really want to give her some power. Watch this. But she crossing me in the spirit because she keep asking for strength. And I'm trying to give her power. And I'm crying strength. And she crying power. And so she done cried strength for an hour and a half. And I'm trying to give her power. And she leave thinking that she got the victory until she run into her first test and flunk it. And realize that, you know what? What you really needed wasn't strength. You needed some power. So when I come into the presence of the Lord now, I say, not my will, but thine will be done. Thy will be done. Thy will be done. Thy will be done. So when we start out in prayer, we start out, we praising God, we hallowing be his name. We are worshiping his name. Then we're telling him, thy kingdom come, all that you are, God, you come. And when you get to thy will be done, you watch what I tell you is going to happen. Inside the next 7 days, there are things that you have been praying about that you're going to begin to see line up with God. Because all God been waiting on you to say is, thy will be done. Come on, saints. I tell you to call the person's name and say, God, let your will be done. Call your kid's name, God, let your will be done. Speak it over your house. God, everything concerning my house, let your will be done. Not my will, but thine will be done. Over me, God, let your will be done. In my career, let your will be done. I know where I wanted to go, but God, if that's not your will, then erase that and let your will be done. Are you ready? 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 From this day forward, don't do nothing. Don't go nowhere. You won't go to tomorrow with me? Wait, hold on, let me pray about that. Now, you ain't got to be that spiritual. Yes, I do. Because I don't want to be out there in the mall when I could have missed a divine connection phone call. Y'all ain't saying nothing. I don't want to be in the mall when the people done called me for the job and I done missed it. Because I didn't pray about it before I went to the mall. Come on, somebody. See, when you start getting to this level right here, every area of your life has got to become governed by the will of God. There's no more pleasure. You are out to serve and to please God. Regardless of what your best friend is doing, you are determined, I'm not going to miss no divine deposits. I'm not going to miss no divine connections. I'm not going to miss, oh my God, nothing that God has for me being in my own will. Because I'm going to tell you what's going to happen today. He's going to catch us up. That's what he told me this morning on my way here. He said, I'm going to catch him up. He said some stuff that's been lingering that should have been done. I'm getting ready to catch them up. He said, when they start praying today and telling me, Lord, let your will be done, there's some stuff that I'm just going to, almost like a computer, like. He said, because they've been messing up the whole puzzle with all this individual prayer. Fix it over here, God. Work it out over there. Give me this. Give me that. Don't do that. Cancel that. Oh, God. Hit me over there. He said, today, he told me. He said, about me. He said, today, he said, all these other things that you got weighing on you, he said, I've just been waiting on you to say, Lord, let your will be done. Lord, let your will be done. He said, because nobody can fix it faster than me, and nobody can fix it like I can fix it. He said, because when I work it out, I'm going to work it out, and it's going to be to your advantage. I don't hear nobody saying nothing. It's going to be to your advantage. You know why? Because you're the prayers of the righteous. Do you know why? Because God has said, you found favor in the Lord's eyesight. force of God and pull him down. Begin to tell him how wonderful he is, how glorious he is, how his power is like none other. Begin to worship him right now. Come on, begin to tell him you're Jehovah Jireh. You're my provider. Come on, open up your mouth. Begin to tell him who he is. God, you're Jehovah Nissi. You're the man that watches over me. Come on, begin to say it with some strength. Come on. He's gonna flip your wheel over today. Come on. That's it. Come on, tell him who he is. Remember everything that you say that he is. He becomes that in your life. He becomes that to you. Come on, worship him. Come on, worship him. Worship him. Come on, worship him. Come on, worship him clear. Come on, worship him clear. Come on, worship him. God, you are it. God, you are Jehovah Jireh. God, you are my provider. God, you are Jehovah Nissi. And I worship you today. I glorify your name. Come on, somebody tell him how much you glorify him. Somebody tell him how much you glorify him. Somebody glorify him. Somebody glorify him. Come on, glorify him. Oh, come on, you're not magnifying the Lord. I'm talking about worshiping him for real. Not just with your hands half mad. Come on, lose yourself in the worship. Because remember everything that you say that God is. He becomes that for you today. Come on, I magnify you, God. Come on, I magnify you, God. I glorify you, Jesus. Oh, I lift your name up on high. You're the one, God. You're the one. You're the one. You're all that I need. I need not come in your presence begging and pleading. But God, I know that you are Jehovah Jireh. I know you're my provider. I need not come in your presence feeling guilty about what I've done wrong. Because I know, God, that you are Jehovah Sitkanua. You are my righteousness. And I embrace your holiness. I embrace it today. Somebody come on, tell him. I embrace your holiness. I embrace your righteousness. And God, I praise you. And I worship you. Because you are Jehovah Nissi. You're the banner that watches over me. You mow down my enemies. When the enemy comes to attack me, God, you are my defense. I need not worry about what my enemies shall do to me. For you are my banner. You fight for me. I need not fight. Somebody come and open up your mouth and begin to worship him. Because you know today that no matter what comes your way, he's fighting for you. You don't need to fight. But the word of God says that you need not fight in this battle. For the battle has already been fought. And the victory is won. Somebody come on, give him a praise in here today. Come on, give him a praise in here. Give him a praise in here. Come on, a few more minutes, saints. I feel the anointing raising. I feel the presence of the Lord increasing in here. Come on, a few more minutes. A few more minutes. A few more minutes. A few more minutes. Come on, the anointing is increasing. Come on, shut your eyes. Begin to lose yourself. The anointing is increasing. You may want to get on the floor. You may want to come down to the altar. The anointing is increasing. I'm getting ready to work it out. I'm getting ready to work in you. I'm getting ready to slay your will in my presence. Somebody come and open up your mouth. Come on, open up your mouth. Come on, open up your mouth. Come on, today is not the day to whisper. Open up your mouth. Oh, glory to God. Come on, give him glory. Let's hear young people give him glory. Is there anybody in here? That's right, my sister. Begin to bow before him. Begin to give him a wave offering. His glory is in this house today. Come on, saints. I feel the anointing. dropping in here. I feel his presence dropping in here. Come on, I feel his presence dropping all the way in the back. Everybody begin to worship him. Begin to worship him. If you can't get any closer, just kneel down where you are. Come on, worship him. Don't stop worshiping until you feel his glory. Come on, come on. I worship you, God. I worship you, God. Come on, he's getting ready to move in here today. I worship you, God. I worship you, God. I worship you, God. You're Jehovah Shalom. You are my peace. Come on, somebody tell him you're my peace. You're my peace. You're my peace, God. You're my peace, God. Come on, worship him. Come on, we can get ready to go to the next level. Come on. Come on, tell him you're my peace. Come on, you're my peace, God. You're Jehovah Shalom. I'm not confused. I will not be depressed. I will not be tormented by satanic forces. I worship you today. I pull down peace in my life. Come on, somebody pull it down. Somebody pull it down. Somebody pull it down. Pull down peace. Pull it down. Come on, begin to pull down peace. Begin to pull down peace. Begin to pull down peace. Yes. 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 Begin to pull down peace. Come on, lay your hands on your head. Begin to decree it to be so. The devil can't trespass in your mind. The devil can't trespass. Begin to lay your hands on your head and begin to call down Jehovah Shalom. Come on, Jehovah Shalom. Oh, come on. Yes. Yes. Come on, feel the peace coming. Come on, his peace is coming. Begin to pray in tongues. Begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Come on, pray in the Holy Ghost. I'm giving you peace today. I'm giving you peace beyond understanding. I'm giving you peace like you've never had before. Yes, 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 yes. Come on, begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. I'm binding confusion. I'm binding up depression. I'm casting it out. It can't stay in the presence of peace. Come on, somebody. He's doing something powerful in the mind. In the mind. In the mind today. In the mind today. In the mind today. The things that you could not figure out, I'm making clear right now. He said, begin to praise him. The thing that you could not work out, I'm making clear. I'm bringing the answer. Somebody begin to worship him for peace. Come on, you just can't stand there. You just can't stand there. You just can't stand there today. Come on, worship him. Not just for peace right now, but peace in the future. Peace for the future. Peace for the next hour. Peace for the rest of the day. Peace for the rest of the week. Come on, let's worship him. Yes. I'm giving you peace. I'm giving you peace. I don't know why the Holy Ghost is saying right here, but he said, somebody need my peace. Somebody need my peace. Somebody needs my peace. Oh, come on and worship him. Oh, he's doing a mighty work in here right now. Come on, something's getting ready to happen if he gets showed up. Come on, a few more seconds. A few more seconds. Come on, speak. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Louder, louder. Your tongues today is backing the enemy up. Your tongues today is pushing him out of your zone. Come on, pray in the Holy Ghost. Your tongues today is letting the devil know that my mind is covered with Jehovah Shalom, that my life is covered with Jehovah Shalom, and you are trespassing. Come on, somebody, pray in the Holy Ghost. That's it, baby. That's it, that's it, that's it, that's it. That's it, sweetheart. That's it, that's it, that's it. He's doing something for you, honey. Yes, and that baseball hat. Oh, do it, do it, do it, God. Do it, God. Do it, God. Do it, God. Oh, baby, he's doing something for you. Yes, he is. Yes, he is. Come on, keep praying. He's doing something for your mind, honey. He's doing something for your marriage, honey. I can see it, baby. Right there in that baseball head, I can see it. And that scarf around your neck. He's doing something for your mind today. He's doing something in your house today. Somebody come on and praise him. Come on, saints, there's a mighty wind in here today. There's a mighty anointing in here today. There's a mighty anointing in here today. Come on, louder, louder. Come on, louder. Come on, with fervency, with power. Come on, the anointing is getting ready to shift. The anointing is getting ready to shift. In about 5 seconds, begin to shout in the presence of the Lord, thy will be done, thy will be done. And then begin to say, yes, Lord, not my will, but thine will be done. Come on, do it now. Do it now. Come on, do it now. Thy will be done. 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 Thy will be done, oh Lord, thy will be done. Thy will be done. Not my will, but thy will be done, oh God. Not thy will, but thine will be done, oh God. Somebody tell him, not my will, but thine will be done. Not my will. Not my will. Not my will, but thine will be done. Oh, come on, he's doing some stuff. He's shifting some things. He's rearranging some stuff in your life. I just heard the Holy Ghost said, I'm rearranging some stuff in your life. Come on, say, not my will. Not my will, but thine will be done, oh God. Come on, surrender, surrender, surrender. Surrender, surrender, surrender. Begin to tell him, yes, Lord, and surrender. Begin to tell him, yes, Lord. Begin to tell him, yes, Lord. Begin to tell him, yes, Lord. Begin to tell him, yes, Lord, and surrender. Yes, Lord, and surrender. Begin to tell him, yes, Lord. I've been doing it my way. I've been doing it my way. But today I yield. I yield my ministry. I yield. I yield my career. I yield to you, Lord. I yield. I yield. Come on, I surrender my will. I surrender my will. Come on, I see some things happen in the spirit. Come on, you can't stop. You can't stop. Somebody begin to tell them, yes, Lord, you can't stop. Begin to tell them yes. 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 Come on, everybody, everybody, everybody. Begin to tell them yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes, Lord, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord, yes to your will. Yes to your way. I give up my will. I give up my way. I surrender to your purpose. I surrender to your will. Not my will, not my will, not my will. Not my will, not my will. Not my will, not my will. Not my will, not my will, not my will. Not my will, but thy will be done. Come on, he's doing it. Yes. Come on, begin to tell him yes with everything you got.
Yes.
Come on, somebody say it for real. Yes. Oh, yes. Yes. Come on, give up, give up, give up, give up, give up. Give up, give up, give up, give up, give up, give up. Yes. Get up to him, get up to him, get up to him. Get up to him, get up to him. Yes. Come on, begin to clap your hands and tell him yes. Begin to clap your hands and tell him yes. Come on, 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 Zion. Come on, Zion. Tell him yes with all of your might. Tell him yes with all of your strength. Tell him yes. Tell him yes with everything now in you. Tell him yes. Come on, open up your mouth. Open up your mouth. Open up your mouth. Come on, tell him yes. 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 something. He breaking something. He breaking something. He breaking something in your mind, in your heart, in your family, in your church, in your will. Yeah, 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 yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Somebody one more time. Somebody one more time. Shout yeah. Until he turned your heart over. Shout yes. Till he transformed your mind. Shout yes. Till he transformed your will. Somebody give him a shout yes.
Praise him. Oh, come on and magnify him.
of praise. Somebody clap your hands, give them a melody of praise. A praise, a praise. Yes, yes, yes. Somebody come on and lift your hands and give them a praise. Oh, somebody give them a praise. Somebody give them a praise. Oh, saints, open up your mouth, open up your mouth. Open up your mouth and give them a praise. Oh, Jesus. Thy will be done. Oh, come on, give them a praise. Somebody give them a praise in here today. I feel the anointing in this house. Oh, come on, somebody got the victory. I feel it. Somebody went to another level. I feel it. Somebody gave God a real yes, Lord. I feel it. Oh, come on, saints. Come on, come on, come on. Yes, Lord. Thy will be done. Thy will be done. So, da 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 da. Oh, come on, grab somebody by the hand right quick. Come on, don't stop blessing the Lord in here. Grab somebody by the hand. Don't stop blessing the Lord in here. Oh, da 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 da. Come on, somebody begin to tell him yes, Lord. Come on, somebody begin to tell him yes, Lord. He said, as we hold hands today, we're making a corporate statement that the body of Christ as a whole, we're standing proxy today for the nation. And we declare in the spirit that the nation will begin to tell God yes, that every church, that every congregation begin to tell God yes. Everybody in here, begin to tell him yes for your church. Begin to tell him yes for your pastor. Begin to tell him yes for your family. Come on, tell him yes. Tell him yes. Tell him yes. Come on, there's a yes, Lord, that's being birthed in here. There's a yes, Lord, that's being birthed in your church. That's being birthed in the nation. Tell him yes. Across the nation, I hear the Holy Ghost say that the prayer that we're praying today is going to be felt across the nation in the spirit realm. Tell him yes. You're doing, but behind this yes, Lord, your family is going to begin to surrender. Behind this yes, Lord, your family is going to begin to surrender. Your church is going to begin to surrender. Your pastor is going to begin to surrender. There's a yes, Lord, that's being birthed in here today. There's a yes, Lord, that's being birthed in the city. There's a yes, Lord, that's being birthed in New York. Tell him yes.
Thank Everybody begin to sing in the Holy Ghost. Oh, ra 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 ra. Yes. Begin to sing in the spirit. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, everybody, begin to sing in the spirit. Hallelujah. Open up your mouth and begin to sing. Sing in the Holy Ghost. Sing to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Sing Hosanna to the King of Kings. Sing Hosanna to the Lord of Lords. Come on and sing, sing, sing. Sing, sing, sing. Come on and sing. Come on and lose yourself in the Holy Ghost and sing. Hallelujah. Glory to you. No one above you. Hallelujah. Come on, he's gonna do something for you while you're singing. Sing to the Lord. Whatever you're saying, just sing it. If you're praying in tongues, just sing it. Hey. Lord, oh ye people, sing, sing to the Lord, oh ye people, sing, sing to the Lord, oh ye people, sing, sing to the Lord, let the redeemed begin to sing, sing to the Lord. All ye people sing, sing to the Lord. All ye people sing, sing to the Lord. All ye redeemed, sing the redeemed, sing to your King. Hallelujah.
I stand in all of you, in all of you. Touch three people and say, "Thy will be done, thy will be done, thy will be done." Touch three people and say, "Thy will be done, not mine." Touch three people, come up, say like you mean it, say, "Thy will be done, not mine." Tell them, whatever it takes, I want his will to be done in my life. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Somebody give him a prayer. Hallelujah. Somebody give him a praise. Come on, church, one more time. I stand. Yes, I stand. God, you're amazing. You're amazing. Holy God, to you, all of my praise is due, because I stand in awe of you. From the top, come on one more time. Everybody say, I stand in awe of you. You amaze me at the things that you do. I stand in awe of you. Holy God, to you my praise is due. Lord, I stand in awe of you. Every Tuesday morning, we ask for faith walkers. We ask for people to sow a $20 seed or more as a prayer seed. Come from all over the building and lay it on the altar.